Umumi tuvalet nasıl kullanılır? İlk olarak kabinden içeri girdiğinizde dikkatli olun. Kapının kulbunu tutmamaya çalışın. Çünkü insanlar tuvaletlerini yaptıktan sonra kabinde ellerini yıkamadan kapının kulbunu açarak dışarı çıkarlar. Çünkü kabinde el yıkayacak bir yer yoktur. Bu yüzden kapıyı küçük bir parça tuvalet kağıdıyla açın ya da kapının kulbunu tuttuktan sonra o elinizi başka bir yere değdirmemeye çalışın. Şimdi tuvaletimizi yapmak istiyoruz. Önce sifonu çekmeliyiz ve bunu yaparken klozet kapağını kapatmalıyız. Böylece etrafa mikrop yayılmasını önlemiş oluruz. Eğer genç isek ve herhangi bir hareket kısıtlılığımız yoksa tuvalete oturmadan çömelerek tuvaletimizi yapabiliriz. Aynı zamanda bacak kaslarımızı da çalıştırmış oluruz. Bu şekilde işerken klozetin üzerine sıçratmamaya özen gösterin. Eğer bu pozisyonda bir süre durup tuvaletimizi yapabiliyorsak, sadece klozetin iç kısmına tuvalet kağıdı koymamız yeterlidir. Klozetin içine koyduğumuz tuvalet kağıdı, çişimizin ve orada bulunan diğer mikropların üstümüze sıçramasını önler. Eğer genç değilseniz ve hareket özgürlüğünüz kısıtlı ise ya da bacaklarınız yarım çömelme pozisyonunda uzun süre durup işeyecek kadar kuvvetli değilse, o zaman klozetin üstünü de temizlemeniz gerekir. Islak mendille silip sonra üzerine tuvalet kağıdı ile döşeyebilirsiniz. İşiniz bittikten sonra kağıtları klozete itip sifonu çekin. Dışarı çıkarken kapı kulbuna dikkat edin.
During first deep lockdown, we went for a trip to a historic city, which is normally very touristic. The city was empty, just few people exploring this UNESCO treasure. It was 10 days until the lockdown should end. Just coffee places had open windows. After cruising the city with my family, we went to the city information to ask if there are public toilets open. I was pregnant, my friend was on her menstruation, and the lady in the information told us the public restroom was going to be open after the lockdown will end. It was impossible to find a hidden spot in the city for us, just for our boyfriends. In the end, we waited under the gas station, but it was approximately 1 hour. I was so pissed off. I read the book Feminist City back then, and my blood was boiling. Like a lot of other issues, bathroom access became visible to me as an urban concern when I had an infant and then a toilet-training toddler in tow. I quickly learned that department stores were our best bet for emergency diaper changes, spots to nurse, and a decent level of cleanliness and provisioning. As spaces built with the comfort of women in mind, department stores, while not always explicitly set up to best serve mothers, were spaces where the bathrooms were likely to be spacious, have lots of stalls, be elevator or escalator accessible, have a chair one could sit in to nurse, offer baby changing stations, be a safe space to leave a stroller outside, and so on. On particularly messy outings, there were also places I could buy a quick change of clothes to replace a poop-splattered onesie. In fact, department stores remain my go-to places to go, whether I have a kid with me or not. Unfortunately, urban department stores are disappearing, and with them, their comfortable and accessible bathrooms.
Die gesamte Welt befindet sich in einer Krise. Und wir mussten trotzdem morgens um 8 Uhr vor die Tür und durften erst um 18 Uhr wieder in die Einrichtung. Nur noch eine eingeschränkte Anzahl von Frauen durfte in der Unterkunft übernachten, also waren die anderen auf der Straße gelandet. Ich bin manchmal tagelang Bus gefahren, weil alles andere ja geschlossen hatte. Nicht mal zur Toilette konntest du gehen, was sollen schwangere, obdachlose Frauen da machen? Ich musste lernen, aber die Cafés und Bibliotheken hatten geschlossen. Die Träger der obdachlosen Einrichtungen haben das absolut nicht mitgedacht. Und dann die Polizei. Als die Pandemie losging, konnte ich nicht mal mehr im Park auf der Wiese sitzen, ohne von der Polizei angesprochen zu werden, wieso ich denn nicht zu Hause sei.
Thank you. J'ai essayé de me mettre à la cup il y a 2 ou 3 ans, je crois. Et c'est vraiment en commençant à l'utiliser que j'ai commencé à être attentive à la manière dont les toilettes étaient organisées dans mon école. Un jour, j'ai vidé ma cup aux toilettes sans remarquer que le lavabo était hors des cabines et j'en ai un peu mis partout. Je savais qu'il y avait quelqu'un d'autre dans les toilettes d'à côté, donc j'ai dû attendre de l'entendre partir pour sortir des toilettes et pouvoir rincer ma cup et mes mains pleines de sang, en priant pour que personne n'entre et voit le lavabo tout rouge avec mon sang partout. Et après quelques temps, je savais exactement quelles toilettes je pouvais utiliser ou pas quand j'avais mes règles et lesquelles j'évitais, alors que avant je m'étais jamais vraiment attardée sur la place du lavabo. C'était vraiment pas quelque chose qui était important pour moi. Je sais que certaines de mes amies ont toujours une bouteille d'eau et des lingettes dans leur sac au cas où elles doivent rincer leur cup dans des toilettes où il n'y a pas de lavabo dans la cabine.
Muss man die Klofrau bezahlen? Steht neben dem Waschtisch ein Teller für Münzen, steht es Ihnen frei, ob Sie einen Betrag zwischen 50 Cent und 1 Euro zahlen möchten. Ist die Toilette sauber und gepflegt, ist dies zudem eine kleine Anerkennung für den Service. Das gilt auch für die Klofrau. Sie können, müssen aber nicht zahlen. Zahlen. Rechtlich gesehen ist nämlich bei der Benutzung des Klos kein Vertrag zwischen Ihnen und der Klofrau zustande gekommen. Und somit besteht auch keine Zahlungspflicht. Die Klofrau hat in der Regel einen Reinigungsvertrag nur mit ihrem Auftraggeber abgeschlossen. Also beispielsweise dem Diskothekenbesitzer.
Darin ist die Reinigung der Toiletten
beinhaltet. Sie als Gast haben jedoch keinen Vertrag mit dem Auftraggeber und müssen deshalb die Klofrau auch bezahlen.
Thank you. Thank you. Shackles Reproduction. The Dork. The maid escaped from her service. The thief's wife, after receiving Christ Day church service, publicly confessing her sin in church, expressing remorse, is sentenced only to 3 years work for her trouble. Sent to the spinning house by her foster mother, sluggish and malignant. Sent for 2 or 3 years to improve. For shame. The old or sick, unable to stand. Spin linen instead. The clock will turn grey coals. Blasphemy. Management tried with both starvation and darkness. Vagrant. Prison. Girl. Containment. Punishment. Carding. Spinning. Yarn. Beheaded. Wool scrubbing, carding, spinning, scrubbing, carding, spinning. Convicted of shoplifting. Child murder. Escaping from factories. From malice and begging. Rebellion and laziness. Self-punishment for fornication. Kept together in handcuffs and chains. Arrested at age 13. We break you down. Total isolation holds. You wore your head with us, eyes out. All of you the same. We saw the flogging. The guards beat her. She did not move then. Do not lift your eyes. Window. Cell. The sky. Only dust. Sash. People. Executions for the people. Such crowds. 3,000. 4,000. The death penalty. The guillotine. The last witch.
You're not allowed to do that when you're
female. The strength of every woman behind you.